Good morning, guys. I'm gonna do a little vlog today. Just woke up. My eyes are still a bit watery. I'm gonna show you my current favorite breakfast. It's so sunny today. Such a gorgeous day. And it's gonna be sunny all week. So yeah, I'll show you guys what I've been eating for breakfast recently. So I freeze two bananas the night before. And it's basically a homemade ice cream. But I like to have it for breakfast as well. So I'm gonna pop it into Thermomix. Then add some oat milk or almond milk. Just got this rich oat drink. Tastes really, really nice. So just a little bit of that. But don't add too much because otherwise it can turn out too watery. And then I started using Sapio Beauty Collagen. This is for hair, skin, nails and joints. And it tastes really nice, to my own surprise. So two scoops of that. I have really, really bad joints, so I'm hoping that this will improve them, like my wrists, my ankles, it's all really bad. And then I take vitamin C, and I feel like this is such a nice way to take my supplements, one little scoop of that, because I often forget, and when I can add my supplements into a smoothie, a yogurt, a drink, whatever, I feel like it's way easier and it tastes really nice. So this is Acerola Cherry Vitamin C. This is sufficient for 2 months. So yeah, this is what I've been using and adding into my breakfast. So now I'm gonna blend it. This is perfection, because I remember when I added too much, I actually used water instead of oat milk, and it was basically so watery, I couldn't put anything on top. So when you do it with almond milk or oat milk, it turns out like that, and it's just so tasty. I cannot even tell you guys. It's just the best homemade ice cream or breakfast, like for me. Look at that. You can blend it using a blender. Look at that. Oh my God. Okay, so I'm gonna add my toppings. I'm gonna use two kiwis. I made a fresh batch of granola yesterday, so adding that, of course. Lots of blueberries, because I love them. I love almonds, and although there are almonds in my granola, I'm adding some extra almond flakes. Then some coconut flakes. And that would be it. You can add chia seed if you want to as well. And I think I'm gonna add a little bit of peanut butter, this one. And as I mentioned before, peanut butter tends to break me out. As much as I freaking love peanut butter, I cannot have too much of it. This is my super yummy breakfast. And yeah, I'm gonna go make a cup of coffee now. Okay, so for coffee, I'm still having loaf number 7, the red one, and I'm gonna try foam this oat milk. Let's see what happens. My super old milk frother that I left here at my parents'. Because you guys know I have my Philips one, But this one does the job still. Let's see. It's a no brand one from Rimi supermarket. It didn't really work. So this oat milk isn't good for frothing. Okay guys, so this is the breakfast I've been having lately and it's so good. Definitely give it a shot. On the plus side though, this oat milk tastes really good in coffee. It just makes it taste a little bit toasted, sort of. But the breakfast is the star of the day. I mean, it's really important to get your bananas the right consistency. Best breakfast. So I actually alternate, I probably told you that before. So one day I'll have a sweet breakfast like this, next day I'll have eggs. I'm gonna watch the last of Desi Perkins fertility journey. I cannot watch it without getting teary-eyed, so yeah. I might cry while having breakfast. It's sunny today, but God is it cold. I just wanna show you some of my grand's flowers because they're so beautiful. I just can't. Look at Dorian living his best life. Baby! Love these. Honestly, it looks like my grandma made a Versailles in her garden. It's just flowers everywhere. Look at this magnolia. And then these are my mom's. These ones are gorgeous as well. And mom's magnolia. And this is our gorgeous apple tree. When I look at it, it reminds me of Anne from the Green Gables. I also wish you could smell it. It just smells incredible. Okay guys, so I want to give you the last update, the final reveal of my parents' new kitchen. Yeah, I think it's absolutely gorgeous. So this is the tea and coffee section. My dad got an espresso machine exactly like mine for his birthday, so we can have nice coffee here now. This beautiful painting here was gifted by grandmother. It was in her kitchen for the longest time. And she said it would go really nicely here with all of the colors, and it's so beautiful. I have no idea who the artist is, so sorry about that. Then here we have wine fridge, which is super nice. Like so. I really like this drawer. All of the pet food goes in here. The newest addition is these window curtain slash blinds. My mom chose this floral design with hummingbirds. She really liked it, and I think it goes really nicely with the colors of the kitchen. Then we have lots of storage here. This storage unit is for all of the glasses. The only annoying thing is this. Telling my parents to get Alexa, so they might. They're almost convinced. Okay, and then here, again, lots more storage. We have a TV right here. The main kitchen sink. Here's spice heaven. And then here is the whole cooking area. I absolutely love this fume extractor. It's so beautiful. The fridge here. And then this is the kitchen island. This is where I sit and do all my work and just hang out most of the time.
This is my favorite spot. And then these are the hanging light pendants. Paper towel, I love this idea. There's one there as well, in here. The guy installed trash bins today. This was the last addition to the kitchen so that we could sort trash. What else? Oh, the chairs are new as well. They arrived a couple of days ago and they're so beautiful. I love this material. They're so soft and extremely comfortable. So I believe this is the brand. And yeah, they might get dirty really quickly, but oh well. Okay, I'll show you from this angle. So yeah, that's the kitchen. That's the kitchen update. We love hanging out here. We all have our meals, coffee, and just sit and chat in here. It's like a meeting spot in the house now. It's just very cozy and welcoming. And all the furniture, this is not an ad in any way, was made by Alkena, the same guys that did my kitchen. It's on every single drawer. So if you want a nice kitchen, get in touch. But the whole design is by my lovely aunt. So yeah. So I'm just gonna make myself a quick lunch. I'm gonna make bruschetta. I don't have proper ciabatta bread, so I'm just using simple bread. Cherry tomatoes, fresh basil, salt, and olive oil. Now I'm gonna shove the bread in the oven to toast it so that it's nice and crunchy. Okay, the bread is done. I'm now gonna rub some garlic into it. I just added a little bit of balsamic, some pepper, and voila. I just got back from the grocery shop because I needed to buy pet food. That's mainly why I went out, and then I got some things for myself. So yeah, Dorian's favorite pet. I buy all of my pet food at Pet City. It's a really nice pet shop. They have everything, so many different and really good quality brands. So this is Dorian's favorite food, Edgar Cooper, and yeah, it's just a really good brand. 10% of their profits go to charity. They're good for your pets and the planet. So yeah, and it's grain free. And this is Edgar and Cooper Espaniel. So cute. Even the packaging is really nice. It's water-based ink, biodegradable, ethical, so we have lots of information on the food. So yeah, he is crazy about this food. This is free-range duck and chicken with pumpkin, plantain, mango, carrot, cowberry, and pea. And then I got him this one to try, irresistible grass-fed lamb, apple, carrot, pear, broccoli, banana, kale, spinach, beetroot, blueberry. So, seemed really nice. And I actually got some treats from the same brand. So lamb and beef bites, and then Good Boy beef bites. I just gave him a couple, but they're so tiny. So I will not be buying these again. Then I got Barking Heads baked treats. So I have these purple ones for like calming your puppy. And he's not a fan of them at all. So these ones have bananas and peanut butter. 100% natural ingredients. I'm sure you can make these yourself. You don't need to buy treats. For Louis, I got Edgar Cooper Fabulous Chicken food. And then the lady at the checkout gave a little sachet of cat food to try. Then from the same line, I got this food for Louis. Pollocking chicken, ocean fish, and egg. So yeah, this is all of the pet food that I got. Some cat litter for our cats. And then that's everything that I bought for myself. So I got my favorite garlic bread crisp. Some Lay's spring onion just for snacking when watching movies. Then I got angel hair for cooking my rice. Then I got these super cute slippers. They're so soft, and at my parents' home I don't have nice slippers, so I thought I would get these. They're so cozy. Because yeah, I'm staying at my parents' during quarantine, and last summer, actually the whole of last summer, I stayed at my parents' house just because of the nature. I love going out on walks with Dorian, we bike to the beach with family, we go for walks in the forest. It's just really lovely having the garden and also everything, the lake, the forest, the beach all around. So I don't really like staying in my apartment when the weather gets nicer. So yeah, I might stay a little longer here even when quarantine is over. I still work from here, like I have my camera, my laptop, everything. Like I do my work during the day, but in the evenings we all chill out, and weekends are like for spending in nature. I go back to my apartment sometimes, but I'm spending most of my time here now. Okay, then I got some Greek yogurt for breakfast. I actually need to make granola because I'm running out, so I might bake that. And then this one, curd with cloudberries. You guys know I love it. Some bananas. I got my favorite bread because my parents don't eat this bread, so yeah. They don't eat the food that I eat, so I always buy my own groceries. Recently, I tried baking cookies that Hannah Schomburg showed on her Insta stories, and I have some leftover dough. And this is what you need to add on top of the cookies, so I'm gonna bake them. Just for the reference, that's the dough, and yeah, I need to use it up. Then I bought some rhubarb because I'm really tempted to do something with it. Either a healthy snack or a pie or something. I'm just, yeah, I don't know, really crave rhubarb. I love it so much. My grandmother used to grow it in her garden, and as a kid I would just have it with some sugar, like slice it and just have it with sugar. It was so yummy. Then I got some flaxseed to put in my granola, some blueberries for granola as well. And then I saw this beautiful new tea. It's Lithuanian tea, actually. It's Etna, so they make lots of herbal teas, and they released this new line of teas by Dr. E. Šimkūnaitė. So this is for your nervous system, and it's supposed to calm you down, and yeah, it has peppermint, lavender, lots of different herbs. And how stunning is this packaging? It immediately grabbed my attention. I was like, I need to give this a go. Okay, what else did I get? I got some rich oat drink to make my homemade banana ice cream. That's that. Mango, because I want to make chia dessert, overnight chia pudding thingy. Then you guys, my favorite truffle cheddar cheese was on sale, so I got two. It's just the best cheese in the whole wide world for me. And then I got some orange jam, and then two of these glasses because they are so beautiful to me. They remind me of Itala. Yeah, they just look really chic and Scandinavian, and they were discounted, so I only paid €2 for each. I already have wait a sec, I'm gonna show you. So I already have two pink ones. You cannot tell the difference, can you? Yeah, I already have two pink ones and two clear ones, and I bought two more clear glasses. My mom doesn't like these at all because it's like very thick glass but I love them. They will go to my apartment. Then I got some lilies. These are white lilies and they're not blooming yet. The reason I got them is because, hey baby, last time I got these lilies, I'm gonna show you what happened. So when I bought them, they looked exactly the same. They're just discounted supermarket €2 flowers. Look at that. They started blooming and they're just so stunning. I don't know, I cannot stop staring at them. They're so gorgeous. And look how many blooms they have. Oh, they're incredible. So yeah, I got them again because they're absolutely gorgeous. And then lastly, you might have noticed, I got the legendary Vogue Italy. It was the only one left in the shop and I thought I would not be able to get my hands on this because I haven't seen it anywhere, and then I just randomly noticed it and I was like, oh my god, I'm getting it. So yeah, it's I think it's a very historical Vogue and I absolutely had to have it. It's quarantine edition, completely white Vogue. So I'm very, very curious to see what's inside. All right, so that's everything that I bought. My grocery run haul, and yeah, I need to tuck everything away now. Feed Louis, who's dying to be fed right now. Although he had his dinner, so I don't know what's up. And Dorian is running outside, so I'm gonna go play with him outside for a little bit. And these slippers feel like walking on a cloud. They're so squishy and cozy. I love them. So let's give some of these to Louis. He's a very fussy eater. Like, if he doesn't like food, he doesn't like it. So let's see. Louis. Okay. Seems fine. No, he didn't eat it. Louis, come on. I'm gonna make Hannah's cookies now. I'm gonna link her Instagram down below so you can check her highlights for the recipe. Baked them with Twix and Dime caramel pebbles. This is one last cookie, remaining cookie. I burned them a little bit, but they turned out pretty good. The dough is a little bit crumbly, maybe because it was in the fridge. I don't even know. So this is what they look like. They are a little bit too crumbly. That's, yeah, I'm assuming that's because they were in the fridge for a few days. I hope they will turn out nice once they have baked. Okay, so now I'm gonna shove them in the oven for 10 minutes on 200 degrees. So I baked them for 7 minutes and the same thing happened like last time. My Twix burns, so I don't know what's up with that. Maybe that's the setting of the oven. This one looks really good. Look at the melted caramel. So I'm gonna leave them to cool off now.